It's a very interesting conflict that we have here, isn't it? There's clearly a difference between an administrator's or a bureaucrat's vision of a creative city and the reality. And there are people in Amsterdam who really understand the logic of, you know, urban creativity and the fact that in order to have a creative city, you need many different layers of creativity, and you can't just think Apple or Google or Google Glass if you think about a creative city, right? Because what you then get is sort of high gloss shopping street
with all the different brands. I mean,
there are quite a few initiatives who have this sort of left-leaning, squatting background, but have moved into something closer to mainstream culture by trying to keep this heritage they have alive. And I think, you know, places like MediaMatic has a little bit of this history. There are quite a few places in the city.
I'm Enrique from Spain, and I came here to Amsterdam to develop an internship in MediaMatic. I'm an agricultural engineer, and I studied in the Polytechnic University of Madrid. First thing that I saw, it was in a book from a friend of mine there in Spain. It was in my university. When I saw in internet that they were offering to develop an internship here in MediaMatic doing aquaponics, I was very interested, and then I sent them an email, and then they were really happy to host an agricultural engineer also from Spain, because normally in Spain the agriculture is really important. Yeah, my first thing was like through books, and then YouTube has everything. I mean, the internet, you can find everything. It's let's say like hydraulics. There is a lot of hydraulics. It's also biology. It's also like veterinary for the diseases of the fishes. It's engineering, of course. It's agricultural. So it's like everything integrated in only one system. Let's say. But I think that I made a calculation, and it's like for one system, for a family of four people, is enough with one system that you can take every day something, like tomatoes or lettuce or whatever. You can feed the family with only one system. Yeah, for the future, as I said before, it's like to make them bigger, and also to make a calculation, a real an estimation of how many people can you feed with the system, and also how many power, I mean, how many baths you need, and how much money you spend in electricity, in water, in everything. Because these systems, the cool thing is they are really sustainable, because you are recirculating, I think you said, the water all the time, so you are not wasting the water. It's just a few for the evaporation, but it's always the same water.